गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक टू अवर ईवीएस ऑनलाइन क्लास। हाउ आर यू? इन द लास्ट क्लास आई गिवन सम होमवर्क फॉर यू। डिड यू राइट एंड स्टडी देयर आंसर्स? यस। फर्स्ट वन, हु वाज द एडिटर ऑफ अल अमीन? स्टूडेंट्स, डू यू नो आंसर? व्हाट इज द आंसर? सेल अवडिली। Yes, very good. Muhammad Abdul Rahman was the editor of Al Amin newspaper. Second one, what are the services of Muhammad Abdul Rahman? Who knows this answer? You know? Yes, please answer it. Yes, very good. Sit down. Muhammad Abdul Rahman was a great leader. He severely criticized social evils. He was the editor of the newspaper named Al Amin. He criticized the policies of the government through his newspaper. Last one, who is known as the Jhansi Rani of Travancore? Who knows this answer? Do you answer? Yes, please answer it. Ani Maskreen is known as the Jhansi Rani of Travancore. The next, let's make a timeline. All students listen to me very carefully. Make a timeline or prepare a timeline in your notebook. First point, 1741, the Battle of Kulachal. Next one, 1795, shifting of capital to Thiruvananthapuram. Third one, 1910, deporting of Ramakrishna Pilla. The next, 1924, death of Kumaranashan. The next, 1948, first popular ministry in Travancore. The last one, 1956, formation of Kerala. Children, you must study these answers. Children, today we are going to discuss about new chapter. Chapter 13th, Discoveries. What is the name of new lesson? Discoveries. We can talk to a person in any corner of the world. We can reach any part of the world within a short time. Man has set foot even on the moon. Have you ever thought of how we have achieved the wonderful changes and developments that have made our lives easy and comfortable? These are all the result of inventions and discoveries. A discovery is recognizing something that already exists for the first time that nobody has found before. Example, how Columbus discovered the Americas. But an invention is creating something totally new with one's own ideas and development. Now we are going to discuss about some of those discoveries that have made our life comfortable. First of all, I say about discovery of fire. Discovery of fire means theekinte kandupidittam. Can you imagine a world without fire? Students, can you imagine a world without fire? Who discovered fire? How was it made at first? Yes, we don't know how or when someone first lit fire. Man might have seen the fire coming out of volcanoes. Students, what is the meaning of volcanoes? Yes, Agniparvatam. Or he might have seen trees catch fire when struck by lightning. Man can see fire. Trees catch fire when struck by lightning. Struck by lightning means diminished. Probably, man discovered fire by rubbing two stones together. Man discovered fire by rubbing two stones together. Children, in ancient days, there was no light after the sunset. In ancient days means Purathana Kalangalle. There was no light after the sunset. Do you know Malayalam meaning sunset? During those period of time, by rubbing two stones accidentally, they discovered the fire. Once again, I say, in ancient days, there was no light after the sunset. During those period of time, by rubbing two stones accidentally, they discovered the fire. The main sources of ignition before humans appeared were lightning strikes. The main sources of ignition before humans appeared were lightning strikes. The main source of ignition means jolika. Before humans appeared were lightning strikes. The early humans discovered fire by rubbing two flint stones against each other. The early humans discovered fire by rubbing two flint stones against each other. Here are one question. How early man discovered fire? How early man discovered fire? The early man discovered fire by rubbing two stones together. Once again I say, the early man discovered fire by rubbing two stones together. All students can understand about how early man discovered fire? Yes. Children, do this activity. Rub your hands for 1 minute. Rub your hands for 1 minute. Put them against your cheeks. Put them against your cheeks. What do you feel? Children, do this activity. Yes, what do you feel? Yes, we feel hot. What do you feel? We feel hot. Then rub a coin strongly over the floor. Rub a coin strongly over the floor. Does it get heated? Students, does it get heated? Yes. When any two surfaces rub against each other, they become hot. When any two surfaces rub against each other, they become hot. Or students can understand. Then rub two pieces of stones. What do you observe? Rub two pieces of stones. What do you observe? Yes. If the stones are hard, sparks of fire will be emitted. If the stones are hard, sparks of fire will be emitted. Children, observe what happens when you rub a matchstick on the side of a matchbox. Students, please observe what happens when you rub a matchstick on the side of a matchbox. Matchbox means teepatti. What do you observe? When you rub the match on the box, you get friction, which means you get heat. Friction means sangarsham. This heat causes a small amount of the red phosphorus chain to be broken apart. Next, I say about from stone to gun. From stone to gun. Children, think about ancient man. think about ancient man means puratana manushyar. Where did they live? Students, do you know where did they live? Ancient men lived in caves and jungles. Then what was their food? Do you know what was their food? Yes, they ate naturally available nuts, fruits and roots. They ate naturally available nuts, fruits and roots. How did they catch animals? They used sharp pointed weapons made of stones. They also used the bones of the animals as weapons. They used sharp pointed weapons made of stones. Kalluvondakkiya weapons aayudhangale. And they also used the bones of the animals as weapons. Animals inde ellukale weapons aayittu aayudhayittu ubayichirunnu. Then next, what weapons did they use? They disabled the animals by throwing stones or hitting with sticks or killed them by beating. They disabled the animals by throwing stones, kallonde erinjittu, or hitting with sticks, vadiyonde adichittu, or killed them by beating. Children, observe the pictures. People have used weapons in warfare, hunting, self-defense and criminal activity. Weapon also serve many other purposes in society, including use in sports, collection for display and historical displays and demonstrations. As technology has developed throughout history, weapons have changed with it. In olden days, men used weapons made of stones. In olden days means in ancient days, men used weapons made of stones. Then they began to use bones of animals as weapons. He sharpened stones by rubbing against each other. That time he saw a spark. While making weapons like these, quite accidentally, he might have learned how to make fire. He knew the power of fire. Can you imagine what he did with fire? Students, can you imagine what are the uses of fire in olden days? Yes, he used fire to keep away wild animals. He used fire to keep himself warm. He used it to roast the flesh of animals. He used it for cooking food. All students, listen to me very carefully. And all students say loudly, children, what are the uses of fire in ancient days? Or what are the uses of fire in olden days? He used fire to keep away wild animals. He used fire to keep himself warm. He used it to roast the flesh of animals. He used it for cooking food. List down the other things that man made using fire. What are the other things man made using fire? List out the other things that man made using fire. Answer is charcoal, metallic tools, ornaments, agriculture implements, in steam engines, as signals, and for making bricks and tiles. Once again, I say charcoal means kari. Metallic tools means lohangalde tools. Ornaments, abandangal. Agriculture implements means krishipanikubekuna, ayudangal. In steam engines, as signals, for making bricks and tiles. Students, now I give you some homework for you. Write in your EVS notebook. Write how early men discovered fire. What are the uses of fire in ancient days? What are the uses of fire in olden days or ancient days. Third one, list out the other things that man made using fire. Third one, list out the other things that man made using fire. Children, now I wind up this class. I hope you can understand this class. If you have any doubt, you can ask through WhatsApp. Thank you.